Dick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports. And it tips off in today's game between the New Mexico Lobos and the Kentucky Wildcats.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Wildcats should be in for an easy one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First, don't let the other team dictate the tempo and the pace. Play at your speed, baby. Next, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. Finally, get busy battling for the boards. Winning teams always rebound well.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Up fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Poor decision there to shoot that three.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Both teams looking to get things going here. The power forward handles the pass. Off the rim and no good. The small forward receives the ball. He takes a three. That's an ill-advised shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
The center handles the feed. Thinks about the shot. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The ball goes out of bounds. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Looking for a good shot. Inside for the bucket. Doesn't go. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Way off target. Number 10 receives the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. As one of the better players on the team's roster, he's expected to make big plays, isn't he, Dick?
Hey, Brad, he's expected to do all the things that will put them in a position to win at the end of the day.
Inside. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Can't get the shot to drop. Momentary look from three-point land. From left of the circle.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. The ball goes out of play. Pack it inside. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. He shoots from the top of the key. No.
The pressure's getting to him, Brad.
He fires it up. Nice shot.
The replay will give us a better look.
Fed the low block. They work it around the perimeter. He dials long distance. Goes in.
You're going to be seeing this one all week.
turnover. Number 32 is fired up and ready to go.
Hey, can you blame him, Red? He's getting it done.
The Lobos have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
High post flashes. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning a battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway. Around the perimeter.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
He shoots from right of the circle, off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. He stole the ball, great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler and he lost it.
On the inside, jumps into the defender.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. Trying to draw the foul.
That's hot.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Barishnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. They'll work it around the arc. Looking for contact. Number 32 makes the finger roll. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Number 10 comes up with it. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Gets it back out for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Fakes. Big man spins down in the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
Gave it up. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He uses the shot fake. He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
For the bucket, perfectly executed. Gave it up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Can't get the shot to go. Working it around the perimeter. Jumps in. And the ball goes out of bounds. He'll regroup the offense. Trying to draw some contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
Gave it up. Looks at the three. It's good.
Cue up the replay, fellas.
To get the D to bite. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
On the dribble, gives it up.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Oh, yes. Entry pass in the paint. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Shot clock is dead. And he'll kick it back outside. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and add a spin move to the goal.
That's a great play. What a play. Demonstrating unbelievable skills. Now look at him. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
Hey, he's dancing, baby. A dancer. I never knew that. I'm surprised.
With the freebie. Gets the first. Need to make that. He tries to beat the buzzer. At halftime, the Wildcats are up by 7. We've had a tooth and nail battle so far, Dick. What was the play of the half, do you think?
My ally, Brad, has to be the great work in the paint so far. It'll be interesting to see who keeps it up in the next half.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. New Mexico has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turning over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Buries it. The Wildcats are up by 10. For the deuce. Drains the shot. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Way off target. Both teams looking to get things going here. And the ball goes out of play. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnover.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. Fakes a jumper. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. He misses from way outside.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Screener gets the worst of that screen with the elbow. For the bucket. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Gave it up. Picks off the pass.
My goodness. Players these days and their athleticism basically jumping up in the air and then deciding what they're going to do. I'll tell you, it must be nice. Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He shoots from right of the circle. He drains the long-range bomb. Picked off.
Hey, kid's got, he posterized them. Replay, please.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
They move it into the front court. Number 22 grabs it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense, poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. They're allowed to convert, get the number game going.
This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 and how to explode to the goal.
Now they work it around the perimeter. In the paint. Leans in. And he scores it off the glass. Shoots it. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. It's stolen. Change in possession. The defense knocked it loose, then went and got it. Kentucky are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Picked off. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. He shoots from the elbow.
He made good use of the screen, but the shot fell off. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He intercepts it.
Look at that spacing.
Number 15 draws the personal.
Show me that one again.
Number is a great play. These kids have all the momentum now. Look at them. They're celebrating.
Hey, Brad, the kids are fired up and having a lot of fun.
Number 15 going to the line for the first time tonight. He can't buy one. Jumped in front to take it away. The center with the ball. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They're working around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. The shot from the baseline. That was nice. Gave it up. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Looking for the foul. He gets that one to fall.
Double team now, bad angle.
He takes the shot off the baseline. Rims out.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Moving it around the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Picked out of the air. Goes up for two. Basket falls despite the contact. Takes the pass in the paint with a little baby hook off the rim and no good. Intercepted. And back they come the other way. Goes up for two. Easy one. Seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Tries for two. He takes the rebound. Fakes the shot.
Pressure that basketball.
For the deuce. Very poor positioning on the double team there, Dick.
These kids know better. We'll see if they get it right next time down.
They'll work it around the arc on the outside. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Rims out. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Back to the action now in the half court. Let's see what they set up, Dick. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad. Coming inside.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
Don't waste a lot of time. Foul right away.
The small forward takes the pass. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it? Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Full house. And a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped for the foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
To the line. Up and in. Hits the second.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Shot clock is dead.
That's basic.
He takes the three. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Wildcats came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I'll tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.